What is going on, guys? Today we will be playing this new roguelike chess-themed game called Pawn Barbarian, as in a combination of the words pawn and barbarian. I wish I knew how to pronounce that word, but that is what we are doing anyways. So, I guess we'll start with the tutorial town, and as far as I'm aware, the game basically allows us to only move by these chess pieces, and once we reach the top of the rank, we get to promote our pawns similarly to how it works in chess. And this is just a tutorial, so it should be easy. So now we just want to end. We have two moves. I think there are pieces that allow you to get extra moves, but so far we don't need them. And at the end of the two turns, if you stop at one of those demo dungeon, get wrecked, ye who enter here. So at the end of the turn, if you're in a square where in the corners it has those red lines, you'll take damage equal to the amount of the lines there. And as far as I'm aware, the game is insanely hard, so I am a tad bit worried, but oh yeah, we kind of did take unnecessary damage there. And the way I found this game was actually from Anna Rudolph's stream. She streamed this maybe like not yesterday, but like the day before that, maybe. Unless I'm mistaken. So the goblins are nimble when attacked. I think both of them are here. And that just means we have to push them to next to a wall or another creature, or otherwise they just escape us. Of course, this one does have a limited amount of charges, so I guess there is that. But I think we can go here now, since it's posed next to the other one, so it doesn't have enough room to move. And this one had charges, so it's not. So we technically could just, but of course this just instantly kill him. Now we could have just started pushing him to waste those charges, but I don't think we need to. And yeah, here is the ability, the cantrip, which allows us to get a new action and draw a card. There is of course also a shield, and these splash damages either diagonally or up, down, and sideways. I think we just save the four. We don't need an extra heart. We have four at the moment. I guess we move here since we get a shield from this piece. Doesn't this just kill everything? Well, we have like a super queen. That's cool. I guess we want some more shields, since this is supposedly pretty hard, and since damage doesn't just disappear even after we change the map or advance to another level, I mean. But now since this is here, does that just mean that the ones it spawns, most of them won't spawn? Because yeah, it does. Because of course, the rest of them aren't on the board. So I guess we move here first, then we move one forward with the king, and I mean we could just go here and here, and I guess we could just go to this corner. Oh, the armor doesn't actually stay over the turn. That's a tad bit annoying. I'm guessing this is where the hard part starts, since I do remember Anna Rudolph having a lot of trouble with the game. So, let's see, yeah, and this is coming at us with a completely different vibe. I guess we could go here. Damaging these two. And then we could just escape back here and take zero damage. I guess we move here first. Then here, then here, and oh, I guess we just move here as to not take damage. Oh no. Oh well. And we can see that squares, they're attacking by just hovering over them, but of course just having the red lines on the corners of the squares kind of does the same job just as well. I guess we go here and then here. Now this is a tad bit inconvenient for us, since we definitely wanted to be able to just directly attack him, but if we go here, I think the knight works in a way where he is going still, it's escaping diagonally. Oh, we are going to have a super pawn. That's nice. I think that's all the effects we have in the game on one pawn. But our knights are basically useless, which isn't the best thing ever. I guess I go here and then, oh, it's this one attacking us. So maybe we just escape. Oh wait, but we aren't in a rush to escape, since we can always just go there. I guess we attack twice. So here, here, here. Oh no. Oh wait, never mind. We don't actually take damage here. But we are surrounded by squares that instantly kill us. Oh well. That would only matter if we didn't win this round. You don't actually take the damage if you win the game on that round. So that's fine. I mean, I guess our knights are pretty useless, so it would be nice to take this enhancement as well. but we also just have a great rook we could upgrade. I'm not actually sure which one I should choose, but I guess we'll go with the knight. And I really hope 4 life is enough for the final floor. This is completely insane. All of these, of course, create more enemies, so. So now we have to kill them in an order where we aren't just killing ourselves at the same time. Getting rid of a goblin this early is of course quite good. But if I go there, then we don't actually have a great escape square. So what if I go here first and then I just go back and take 1 damage since I had 1 armor as well. Wait, why doesn't it show me the squares? Oh, never mind, it does. I guess we could just go here and kill most of the enemies. And now the matron is at the corner of the board, meaning that there is really not much threat coming from it. I think we just... But if we go here, how much damage will we actually take? Well, I guess we'll find out in a moment. I mean, I guess this is the best choice since... Wait... Yeah, the blight effect kind of does screw us over there. We actually have to draw a knight. Yeah, a knight to not take damage here. And of course we don't, but what we do draw is a cantrip and we get the kill. The floor is clear, we get a mithril lathe. Finally yours, the ultimate cooking utensil. If I'm gonna be completely honest, I was expecting the game to be a lot harder. Especially since I saw how much Anna Rudolph struggled with it. But I guess we just had a lot of luck and drew a ton of cantrips, which meant the game was a lot easier for us than for most people. But a win is a win. Can we actually take the ladle? No, we can't. Oh no, that's so sad. We get to look at it, but we don't get to actually take it. Do we? Yeah, not even with the knight. That's so sad. But anyways, I hope you enjoyed us playing the demo version of Pawnbarian. The full game will come out in the far future. But once it does come, I think I'm going to buy it and probably make a video out of that as well. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please leave a like. If you didn't, please leave a dislike. If you have any game suggestions, feel free to comment those down below. Also, check out my Twitch, which is also Jermolani. And yeah, I'll see you in the next video. Have a good one.